observing cultural relics and learning the stories of Dongpo.
苏轼就喜欢打趣他的字，说是树梢挂蛇。黄庭坚呢就打趣称说苏轼的字呢是蛇压蛤蟆。
Sampling Dongpo's culinary delights while appreciating the poetry behind it.
造型很像荔枝吧？
像啊。
对，但是其实呢，它里面的馅是虾。
Don your cultural hat this week and join me as I visit this 苏轼 themed cultural relics exhibition. The 29th of January 2024 is the 19th day of the 12th lunar month. This day also happens to be the birthday of illustrious Northern Song Dynasty man of letters, calligrapher and painter Su Shi. 2 days after his birthday on the 31st of January 2024, he returns to us from the past as his cultural treasures are put on display for everyone to see here at Hainan Museum.On the 1st of February, the 苏轼 themed cultural relics exhibition was opened to the public. The whole expo revolves around 苏轼's brilliant literary and artistic achievements, his optimistic and open-minded outlook, his contributions to the local populace, and his three 苏's educational style.
我们这次使用了四个展厅，总的展陈面积呢是2600平方米，这是我们博物馆开馆15年以来是规模最大的一个临时展览。展期一共是3个月的时间，这次全国一共有60多家文博单位对我们这个整个展览的那个展品文物进行了大力的支持，尤其是主办方故宫博物院。这次呢就是一次性借展了5件国宝级的一级甲等文物，这是可以说是绝无仅有的，
非常的难得。
对，非常非常难得。
On display are a total of 332 items pertaining to 苏轼。 Alongside his works are those of three other eminent Song Dynasty calligraphers, with this being the first time that the works of these four greats are being exhibited together outside the Forbidden City.
这几件真迹啊，是在2023年的12月份刚刚结束了3年的休眠期。这些国宝级文物啊，它是非常脆弱的这些纸质文物，然后它展出一次之后，会有3年进行入库的保养维护，也就是说6年你才可以看这一次，
不容易哈。
对对对。
苏轼's life is divided into different sections, represented by three different exhibition halls.
那第一个展厅叫东坡一号厅，参观完这个之后呢，您可以就是穿过大厅，然后到那个东坡二号厅，然后出来呢可以上电梯，然后进二楼到东坡三号厅，也就是沉香别院。每个展馆它是有固定的讲解员的，讲解员呢是身着宋服，然后会引导大家进行一些那个讲解。
Dongpo Exhibition Hall 1 presents 苏轼's life before he became a public official, up to when he came to Hainan. The centerpiece of this hall can be found appropriately at its center.
这个就是苏轼的真迹，就是他自己亲笔写下来的2篇书信。整体呢，它有大有小，这也反映出作者当时的一个心情。你刚刚有跟我聊天的时候有说到，就是看到这些字呢，有些笔画很长，然后有些呢又是短短扁扁的。
对，就感觉不规则的，像这个下面这根在那吧，应该是。
对，它就是长长的一笔下来，
好像没有力气继续写。
对，就太痛苦了。
对。
所以呢，这2篇作品可以说是苏轼的早年书法转向中年书法的佳作了。
Among Su Shi's many disciples, Huang Tingjian is perhaps his most famous.
接下来我们要来看到的就是黄庭坚的真迹《为清道人帖》。《为清道人帖》呢，里面就记录了黄庭坚呢称赞为清道人的学识和操守，同时呢也记录了为清道人和张商英的一个交往。这一篇呢是黄庭坚在他50岁的时候写的。黄庭坚的字体偏向于非常劲瘦有力的那种风格，提笔横勾都非常的漂亮。但是呢，因为苏轼跟黄庭坚的关系比较好嘛，所以苏轼就喜欢跟他开玩笑，就打趣他的字，说是树梢挂蛇。那么，苏轼的字呢比较浑厚扁硕，就是扁扁的嘛，比较敦实，所以黄庭坚呢就打趣称说是蛇压蛤蟆。
The four great calligraphers of the Song Dynasty, 苏轼、黄庭坚、米芾and 蔡襄 were posthumously named the four Song-era greats. The oldest of the four, 蔡襄, was deeply revered by 苏轼. His work, 金雎帖, is on show here.
我看它好像有两种书法吧，
和那
个字的不一样啊。
这篇是蔡襄写给好朋友的一封书信，所以呢，他写的比较随意和自然。前半部分采用的是行书，偏向工整方面；后面部分呢，慢慢转向了草书，草书就比较自然随意嘛。所以我们看到他的这些运笔啊，都很潇洒自然。
Exhibition Hall 1 delineates 苏轼's home life. On display are items such as his Ode to the Clever Mouse, written when just 11 years old, and the three strategies of 苏, composed in conjunction with his father 苏洵and younger brother 苏辙. In addition, is a collection of cultural relics that reflect the style of the Song dynasty, such as a Northern Song gilted silver plate with a lychee pattern,and greyish-green glazed longchuan-type bowls and vases, allowing exhibition-goers to appreciate the context and setting, and thereby understand all the better the content of Hall 2.
Well, this exhibition hall is absolutely fascinating as it details the life of 苏轼from his early childhood all the way up to his career as a public official, and even mentions some of his friends and acquaintances from the time.I feel particularly lucky to have seen some highly significant works of his that are usually housed in the Palace Museum in the Forbidden City in Beijing and are only on temporary loan to us here in Hainan.
In the year 1097, 苏轼, who was already in his 60s, took his young son 苏国from 徐文on the Chinese mainland and crossed the sea to Hainan's 澄迈, thus beginning the final chapter of his life of exile.Hall 2 tells visitors all about these 3 years. In Hall 2, the most significant item is perhaps an authentic piece by fellow Song-era great 米芾。
苏轼爱结交朋友，在他的生活当中有一位追星成功的头号粉丝，那便是书法家米芾。米芾比苏东坡要小14岁，他幼年所临摹的字帖便是苏东坡的。在我身边的掌柜中的这件文物便是米芾的行书《道林诗帖》。纵观米芾的书法作品，后代人用八面出锋和锋墙阵马来形容。所谓的八面出锋，指的是它的每一个字、每一根线条都极富动感，张力十足；而锋墙阵马指的是米芾的书法呈现出的遒劲和充满力量的状态了。
In Hainan, 苏轼 made significant contributions in the spheres of culture and education. This is evidenced by the three stone inscriptions from Hainan's historical academies that can be found beside the white glazed figure of 苏轼。On loan from the Forbidden City's Palace Museum.
上方所展现出来的由苏泉书院、汉湘书院，还有琼台书院等等，都促进了海南岛上的教育事业的发展。特别是你看到这一件啊，它是新建汉湘书院的一个石碑的拓片。那么其中我们可以了解到，至宋而闻名建起，始建东坡书院。当时苏东坡在海南岛上传道授业，并且呢是广收学徒，可以说那一定程度上对后世海南岛上的文教事业的发展起到了积极的促进的作用，也可以说是产生了一个深远的影响了。那像比如我们刚刚所讲到的汉湘书院，那么其实它现如今还是在海口市的汉湘小学之内。
哇，就是说今天你还能看到这个书院。
是的，
了不起。
Educational endeavors aside,苏轼 also did a lot for the field of medicine.
像展柜中大家看到的这一件叫苏审内涵良方，它是苏东坡所撰写的苏学释方和沈括所撰写的良方两本书的合编本了。
那书上的内容是什么呢？
说到这本书啊，它其实记载的内容可以说是丰富多彩的，比如说有医理、本草、灸法、养生等等内容，可以说是应有尽有。当时在贬到黄州的时候，他也得了赤眼病，今天看来就是结膜炎了，还不爱忌口，当时有一个多月没有出门。 外边的人都以为他已经病逝的。也许是久病成医，在苏沈良方当中就记载着有点眼熊胆膏等治眼的良方了。
Through his long-term contact with the Li community, Su Shi came up with the concept of ethnic equality.
其实他当时在海南的昌化郡内看到当地的黎族和汉族一起相处，但是呢，黎族的地位不是很高，双方时常会有矛盾。于是他提出的孜尔汉黎均是一民的民族平等思想，有力地促进了当地的民族团结和民族融合。在昌化郡内，他经常看到有一个青年，而同时呢，这位青年也将身上的脊背部送给他进行御寒。像这边您看到的这件呢，就是现代的脊背部。脊背是海南黎族对木棉的称呼，黎族人民采用着木棉制作而成的棉纺织品，可以说是海南棉纺史上，也可以说是中国棉纺史上的活化石的，是中国最早的棉纺织品之一。它距今已经有3000多年的历史了。
In AD 1100, the Song Emperor Hui Zong ascended the throne and granted a general amnesty. At last, Su Shi could return north to the Central Plains region.Here at the exhibition, visitors are able to see an example of the calligraphy style penned by Emperor Hui Zong, characterized by its slim yet sturdy strokes.
掌柜中的这件作品叫《召集行书·蔡行赤卷》，是辽宁省博物馆的一级文物。宋徽宗召集，他自创了一种瘦额劲、秀额润的书法字体，被后世称为是瘦金体。掌柜中，您看到的这幅作品呢，它其实是一道圣旨。上方所记载的是宋徽宗召集不允许蔡行辞去领殿中省之职而颁发的一道圣旨，这道圣旨呢是以精美的金笺纸铸就而成的，此时行间布白疏朗得体，笔墨纤细，写来墨韵流畅，犹如飘腾荡柳之势。
On the 20th of June AD 1100, Su Shi boarded a boat and set sailEn route, he famously wrote, No regret for this deadly journey at the edge of the world. I have lived my life to its fullest. Just over 1 year later, on the 24th of August, Su Shi, in his 66th year, died while heading northwards. The second Su Shi exhibition hall documents his life here in Hainan. Despite being here in exile, he still seems to have been able to retain a distinctly positive outlook on life, having done many things to help the locals, such as digging wells and compiling a catalogue of medicinal remedies. Su Shi had a lifelong love of fine fragrances, and while in Hainan, he developed a keen fondness for its eagle wood.In the Eaglewood exhibition on the second floor, punters can feast their eyes on a range of incense-related historical records.
他在海南的时候，有一次他偶然得到了一块非常漂亮的、状如假山一样的沉香山子，然后又正逢他的弟弟苏哲60岁大寿，他把这块沉香山子赠给了弟弟作为贺礼，还做了一篇《沉香山子赋》赠之。然后在这篇赋当中呢，他写道。既金坚而玉润，亦贺国农经，意思就是借这个沉香来勉励同样被贬雷州、处境不佳的弟弟，希望呢他能保持晚节，做一个立场坚定且精神超然的君子，在逆境中能够品格坚贞，自发芬芳之气。
那就是这块这儿。
是的。
At the Eaglewood Exhibition, incense demonstrations are given at intervals.These are an opportunity for the audience to experience some traditional uses of incense, as well as its zen-like properties. The wonderful and mysterious world of incense. Visitors to this exhibition can learn some rudimentary information, such as how and where incense is formed, and how varieties differ from one another, but also see some rare and priceless examples of natural incense from all around the world.To maximize viewers' enjoyment, Hainan Museum has extended the opening times of the exhibition to include the evenings, when a series of activities and spectacles, such as artistic performances and a market, is laid on.
通过集市呢，是针对我们这一次的这个苏轼主题文物展，创建的一个我们复古了当时宋代的一个人文集市的一个场景。 里面包括了三大区域，一个呢是我们宋代人文户外的活动区，嗯，这样能看到我们这个垂丸、投壶还有蹴鞠。然后我们分时段呢会有志愿者呢带领我们观众来互动，然后还有一个呢是集市卖东西的，还有一个当然就是我们逛夜市不能缺少的美食。
Here at Dongpo Market, 15 stalls offer everything from tasty treats to games to cultural artifacts from all over China, including those that visitors can have a stab at making themselves.
他当时是被贬到我们海南丹州，贬到丹州的时候呢，然后呢有一天下雨，下雨的时候呢他又躲在那个屋檐下面去躲雨，他在农民家里面拿了一个斗笠戴上。苏东坡在我们丹州的话很有威望，老百姓非常喜欢他，然后就取这个名字叫东坡笠。
那跟普通的这个斗笠有什么不同的呢？
首先的话呢它的形状不一样，第二个的话呢工艺不一样，那么其三个的话呢是它的功能不一样。这个帽子是你戴上去不会被淋雨的。
Making a Dongpo bamboo hat is a complex process, with the hat consisting of no fewer than 5 layers.
这个帽子内外都是竹子，把它铺得很薄很薄，里面是竹的是竹心，外面这个是竹面，就是最外面这个面青，它中间还要存两层进去，就上下是芭蕉叶，然后在芭蕉叶中间呢再夹一个葵叶，那么这样的话呢就将
防水的，
对，最后的话呢就是顶上。为什么顶上用藤来做呢？因为藤它有韧性，第二呢防虫防霉又比较好，那么其三的话呢这个颜色跟这个轴子的颜色它有一点点的色差，非常有一种立体感，然后呢一种美感。
To weave a complete Dongpo hat requires more than 50 individual steps. I have a go at weaving part of the bamboo frame.
首先要打个底，我们是按里子编法，那看看啊，是一上一下呢，要小心点，不要把手割到，你要压一压，就是这样的压过来，您可以试一下，
好，
您可以试一下，它整个这个的话呢是要均匀的，你不均匀的话它就它的密度就不一样了嘛。
是，我也把它挪过来。
对，要慢慢的挪过来一点点。然后呢，我们均匀做好的，把这个做好之后的话呢，我们就做成了这么一个形状，做好就把它窝起来，窝起来就做成这个样子。然后呢，你就把它就慢慢的编。
Well, I think it's absolutely fabulous that traditions like bamboo hat weaving, in this case of the typical Hainan style Dongpo bamboo hat, and many others are being actively passed down by inheritors of China's intangible cultural wealth.Su Shi had a well-deserved reputation as a gastronome. At Dongpo Market, an assortment of gourmet snacks is on offer for market goers to taste.
东坡酒楼宣传一下我们的特色，以东坡爱吃的美食为主。
有什么特色呢？
因为我们所做的东坡肉里面有加了一些水果，所以说它这个肉它含有果香，吃的话它反而肥而不腻。
听起来非常的清香好。
对对对对。
但我看你这里摆的不同的菜肴哈，比如说这边有是粥吗？
他喜欢的一种羹，也就做东坡羹。
这边呢，这个看起来非常的神奇哈，
叫东坡荔枝。这呢是东坡最爱吃的肉其中的一道，羊，它是我们是以羊排来做。
Dongpo braised pork was named after Su Dongpo. After having been exiled to Huangzhou, he retained his positivity, which can be seen in his Ode to Pork, written at the time, in which he depicts this now world-famous dish.
Oh, 这个肉很结实，非常好吃。
跟您所平常吃的外面的东坡肉不一样吧？
有一点的那种非常淡的这种甜味，应该是
水果
果香那种，果香味那种。
对对对，
很清香的那种。
对对对，加是有哈密瓜，有西瓜，就以这两种为主，因为西瓜属于清凉，然后呢哈密瓜它有那个甜，清甜那个甜度，而且还有那个清香。
比较适合加到这个东坡肉里面。
对对对对。
Meat aside,Su Shi also had a particular fondness for both shrimp and lychees. These two concepts combined gave rise to an innovative dish.
造型很像荔枝吧？
像啊。
对，但是其实呢，它里面的馅是虾。东坡在那个西湖这边最喜欢的就是西湖那个河虾嘛，然后配那个是西湖龙井嘛，然后呢，他也喜欢吃那个荔枝，说上火嘛。我们为了怀念他而所做他的美食是里面含虾，造型是荔枝。哦，来，您尝试一下这个。哦，
脆脆的、硬硬的，是油炸的吗？
对，它是油炸的，为了定型。
哦，哇哦，
是很像荔枝吧？
嗯，看起来很像，
但是吃起来一点不像。不是，嗯，对。
哇、wow, ，That's very strange。哎，就是外面那个红色的东西是
火龙果，加上面粉慢慢搞成一粒一粒慢慢贴上去。啊，
这个工程挺大的、哦。
对对对，
那个很费时间吧？
是的。
Well, this is a really unlikely combination. It is、shrimp meat inside, all minced up, and on the outside there is、rice powder mixed with dragon fruit for the color, I guess, and then.Put together in this shape and then deep fried.、as I say, an unlikely combination, but actually it works rather well.、Mm. This exhibition covers every aspect of the great man's life, from his childhood to adulthood, to his travels, his political discourse, his culinary masterpieces, and his literary and artistic works. Now, although this exposition is only on for a limited time, it will be showing until the 30th of April, giving you ample time to come along and find out everything you didn't know about this cultural genius.If you ask me what I have done in my life, then I urge you to go and see Huangzhou, Huizhou, and Danzhou for yourselves. This spring, when life is blooming again, why not come and visit a resurrected Su Shi and take inspiration from his timeless works of art and indefatigable enthusiasm?
这里是海南卫视